So, our common errors in food handling include we prepare food for several hours prior to consumption, combined with storage temperatures which favor growth of pathogenic bacteria, which I had mentioned. So most of the times you find that you'll prepare food in the evening, then you have leftovers, then when you're going to work or school, you will warm it, then carry it to work, then eat it cold, or warm it again. So the question that is there is, are you warming the food correctly? Are you cooling the food correctly? Because the purpose of storage of food, for example, if you are cooling food, cooling doesn't kill bacteria, it inactivates it. So when you warm the food, it's like you're waking them up, telling them, get ready for work. So how should you warm that food? You should warm it to an extent that it will destroy the bacteria. And this means that you should incorporate temperature type combination. So if you're warming food, it is advisable that whether you are cooking or warming, the temperature should at least be above 70. Obviously, you will not have a thermometer in a sufuria, but at least you will know what kind of hot it is. So, and you should do it for maybe close to 3 to 5 minutes, because most of us, we just warm food, me included, we just warm food for the sake of removing the cold from the fridge. So that's all about storage. And also, most of us, when we are tending to store our foods, we store a large chunk of food in the fridge when it is still warm. So you find that the food will cool, yes, but the core of the food will still remain hot. And that's a breeding area for microorganisms, which will proliferate when due to continuous exposure. So the same way you warmed food above 70, this is the same way you're supposed to cool food below a certain temperature. And the recommended temperature by WHO is 10 degrees Celsius and below. So if you're cooling food, you should cool it to that extent. If you're cooling to store, you should cool it below 10. If you're warming to either cook it, reheat it, or cook food from raw materials, you should let it cook at a temperature above 70 and at least achieve a good temperature time combination.